Now we begin with the new topic, that is the bending of the beams. What exactly the beam is? A homogeneous body of uniform cross section area whose length is larger compared to its other dimension is called as beam. So this is the beam. The length is more compared to the other, the breadth and the thickness. The length is more, that is we call it as the beam. Consider such a beam. Mn is the beam. It is connected to a rigid support. It is fixed. So one end is fixed. M is fixed to this rigid support, and n, the other end, is free. So such type of the system we call it as cantilever. That is a single cantilever. Now whenever we apply the load to the free end, the bending of the beam takes place. The beam, it bends. Depending upon the load, we can calculate to what extent it is going to bend. Now before getting into that one, we'll try to understand what exactly the neutral surface and the neutral axis with respect to the beams. So we have taken the beam. Let Mn is the beam. We have not applied any the load. At that time, let us consider this beam is made up of n number of infinitesimal layers, small layers. Let AB, CD, and EF for consideration. Let there be a small infinitesimal the layers in Mn, and the CD is known as the neutral axis. This is known to be the neutral axis. Now when such a beam is loaded, when we apply the load, we observe that it is going to bend, and when it is bent, we observe the layer Mn, that the A dash B dash CD E dash F dash. So it is clearly observed that the initially it was AB, now it has become A dash B dash. There is an elongation, we can observe there is an elongation. CD, it is unchanged as it is, so it is the neutral axis, it is not going to change. Similarly, EF, the region below, there is a contraction, we call it as E dash F dash. By bending, there is an increase in the region above the neutral axis, and below the contraction takes place. So with this basic idea, now we are going to define what exactly the neutral surface and the neutral axis. The definition for the neutral surface, it is that layer of a uniform beam which does not undergo any change in its dimension when the beam is subjected to bending within elastic limit. So whenever load is applied within the elastic limit, this CD is not going to change. Its dimension is not going to change even when it is bent. Therefore, it is called as the neutral surface. Then what is the neutral axis? The neutral axis is defined as, it is a longitudinal line along which the neutral surface is intercepted by only longitudinal plane considered in the plane of bending. So this is the axis, it's a longitudinal axis taken into account. Now when the beam is bent, so two cases we are going to study here, that's already we have discussed. The inward pull towards the fixed end for all layers above the neutral surface. So here A dash B dash, if you take the A dash B dash, that those which are above the CD, that is neutral surface, so there is a inward pull will be there. Whenever you bend, there is an inward pull. Similarly, in the E dash F dash, we observe that an outward push directed away from the fixed end, and for all the layers below, means all the layers below CD, there is an outward push. So there is a push, outward push, whenever it is bent. So two cases we we have observed as given here, and outward push will be there and the inward push. So inward pull will be there for the region above the neutral surface, and this outward push away from the fixed end, it is for the below the neutral surface. There's one more, the terminology, that is the bending moment. So what this bending moment is, it is nothing but the moment of the applied couple subjected to which the beam undergoes bending longitudinally is called as bending moment. Now we are going to derive the equation for the bending moment of a beam. The same case which we have discussed right now, the beam and the layers A, B, C, D, E, F. Now when this is bent, so if you take into account, so O is the origin. Now A dash, B dash, there is the elongation, C, D remains same, E dash, F dash, contraction takes place. Let theta be the angle which is subtended. Let R from O to CD up to the neutral axis, that is nothing but the radius R, and small r, it is the distance between the successive layer, that is B dash D, whatever the successive layers, that distance we call it is taken as small r. When such the beam is loaded, we observe that A dash B dash is elongated, CD remains unchanged, that is neutral axis, and E dash F dash, the contraction takes place. So already we have discussed R is the radius of the circle to which that the neutral axis is formed, and theta it is the common angle subtended by the layer at the common center of with respect to the O as the center. Now CD is equal to R into theta. We can observe from the bow diagram, CD, this CD is equal to this distance R into the angle theta. Therefore CD is equal to R into theta. That is CD is equal to R into theta. Now this, the layer AB, now it has elongated to A dash B dash. Earlier it was AB, now it has become A dash B dash. Therefore change in the length, how much the elongation has taken place, that is the change in the length is A dash B dash minus AB. This A dash B dash is equal to R plus R into theta, that is given ABCD is equal to R into theta. The R is the successive distance, therefore A dash B dash is equal to up to CD it is R and plus R, therefore it is R plus R into theta minus AB is R into theta, that is equal to small r into theta. But the original length was AB, that is R into theta. This is change in the length, and original length is R into theta. According to the Young's modulus, Y is equal to longitudinal stress by linear strain. Therefore, now equating longitude, this longitudinal strain is equal to Y into linear strain. Rearranging the term, Y into linear strain. Therefore, Y as it is, the linear strain. What is strain? It is force per unit area. Okay. So this linear strain is equal to R by R, which already we have calculated here. Now this longitudinal stress is equal to F by A, because stress is force per unit area, therefore F by A is equal to Y into R by R, where A is the area of the layer AB, the small infinitesimal area. Therefore, rearranging F is equal to Y A R by capital R. Now, moment of this force about the neutral axis, with respect to the neutral axis, what is the moment of the force? It is equal to the force F into its perpendicular distance from the neutral axis. That is, F into the distance is small r, the interplanar, that is the spacing. Therefore, what is F? F is equal to y a r by r into small r, it becomes y a r square by r. Therefore, the moment of the force acting on the entire body is summation of y a r square by r. We add the summation to get the force which is acting on the entire body of the beam. Therefore, is equal to y by r summation of a r square. So we know that moment of inertia is equal to m r square, or is equal to summation of a r square. Therefore, this is moment of inertia. In this case, this AR, summation of AR square, is represented by IG, where that IG is nothing but the geometric moment of inertia. Therefore, in this equation, okay, we can write down the moment of the force is equal to Y by R as it is, and summation of AR square is represented by IG, that is the geometric moment of inertia. Therefore, now the bending moment is this moment of the force, or nothing but the bending of moment. Therefore, the bending moment is equal to Y by R into IG. This is in case of the beam, that is the bending of the beams, that is bending moment of the beam is equal to Y by R into IG. Now, the expression for this, the bending moment for different geometrical shapes and a cross section area. So directly we take into account the bending moment for a beam of, if it is a rectangular cross section area, the bending moment is Y by R BD cube by 12, where B is the breadth and D is the thickness of the beam. And bending moment for a beam of circular cross section, if it is a circular cross section area, it is given by pi y 4 r into rho cube, where rho is the radius of the beam.